I'm not an ethnic champion. But I feel this was done here because these people are Igbo. And now it affected me. And I'm not speaking out because it affected me. I always speak out on these issues. The man is wicked. And up to this moment, this guy has not addressed the country. Because he thinks he's too big. Where he doesn't earn any money. The people pay him. These people pay their tax. They come here to collect money. All they ask is just to protect this business and protect these people's property. And now his people came and raised it. They were bringing them from Kano, bringing them from just... He knew they were bringing them. We saw even the one they were loading in front of Asoro Presidential Villa. They were marketing people in front of the Presidential Villa. Did the president do anything?
No.
He did not do anything?
No.
He wants to destroy a country he never built? We are not going to give him that space again. Yes. Only if he wants to kill, let him kill everybody. Yes. But he's a wicked man.
Yes. Yes.
And up till now, he has not come to apologize to Nigerians or send these people to come to apologize to people. Look at the business, look at the cars. From here up to that junction, his people burnt it. What did these people do to this guy now? Not talk of the one he opened fire. Removed the CCTV, them and their people in Lagos. Off the street light and started executing and butchering innocent people. These people are barbarians. When you play with human lives, when human life means nothing to you, are you the one making this money? And you're destroying the means of livelihood? What brought about this clash? People were having their procession and protest in the last 2 weeks. Instead of you to produce your own people to rally for you somewhere, because nobody is actually with you again, you now went and imported armed thugs and barbarians and they started shooting from... Look at even the prison they broke. They are the ones who did it. And they planned this systematically with some of their APC governors to unleash these hoodlums as an excuse for placing coffee all over the country to attack the protesters. Even when someone imposed that illegal coffee or whatever they call it in Lagos, it didn't take up to 2-3 hours for the soldiers to be deployed. They all worked this thing out. They removed the CCTV camera so that the atrocity will not be covered. They off the street like, and they started butchering these people. You know, when Ambode said someone has a mental issue, people took it for granted. For somebody that can support this candidate against his people. So all we are asking the president is to be president for one day. Even if the only thing he did is to de-escalate tension and find a way to unite our people to have a middle ground so we can do our business. He has already wasted the entire 6-7 years. But we're asking him to preserve our lives. But our lives look like chicken to him. Is his own life special or that of his children?
No.
All the people that was killed there, let it be his daughter that was killed. Will he be blowing that, sitting in the villa without doing anything?
No.
He thinks he can do anything he likes, go to bed and sleep, but he is a lazy man. The people are paying him.
Yes.
And now he has destroyed my car, destroyed that of my peer, and destroyed that of other innocent business people here. Yesterday night, Nigeria did not know. His talks were here to commit this trap, and we're hearing that I was still going to come back. Has he addressed the nation? Has he condemned the activities of his thugs?
No.
Were they not being carried in security vehicles of government?
Yes.
Did you see the videos?
Yes.
Were they not loaded inside the front of Asorok?
Yes.
On a normal setting, this man is supposed to be declared wanted by the International Criminal Court.
That's
he should be arrested for crimes against humanity. A long time ago. And that's why I told people, when he opened fire on the shy people thought it was about the shy. When you open fire on the IPOP, the talk was about today has opened fire on the entire country. If you leave this man, he will murder everybody.
Yes.
I was asking every night that he keep shouting. We will not give up for him because he never built this country.
We can't give up.
We will never give up for the Buhari. Never.
Never.
And everybody keeps shouting to the international community. This man, whenever he finished, needs to go to the International Criminal Court. He needs to be where Babo is. He needs to be where Chastello is.
Yes.
He has brought a brutal regime on our people, leaving behind traces of blood and destruction. Who is he?
What
are we destroying our lives? We are the taxpayers.
Yes.
All we ask him is protection. Yes. He should stop dividing us along ethnic or religious line. Allow every Nigerian to live peacefully. But he allowed these talks since the last 5 days. And you call yourself a government? You want people to respect you?
No.
How can any person respect him? Look at my vehicle here. And look at that of my peer and other people. What did we do to him that? Was I in the protest? I cannot be a coward. Not because it involves me now. I've been saying this even before I got affected yesterday night. That this were militia working for the president. This were militia with the president people we are funding. We saw them on pictures and videos being ferried in government vehicle, being backed up by security forces. The police was it, didn't do anything yesterday. They wanted, okay, how did the president allow this thing? This was an ex-Sars protest by young Nigerians in Lagos and Abuja. How did him and his people introduce ethnic and religious angle to this? The president is just wicked. He's a wicked man. Not because I'm affected here. My media advisor car, Cosmos, is also born. And they waited, not the time they took, this is an armored vehicle. They waited to heat it up to make sure the glass melt. What did the police do there? So do we have a police or we have a militia police or army or DSS? These are innocent business people doing their business right here. All these vehicles, just like my own, belongs to people, customers who will come and question what happened to their cars. They deliberately wanted to punish them. And they started it up from the tire side, where they were chased away from that side, and they continued to descend. Police allowed them to do this. And what brought us to this point? If there was a protest, and government feel they have their own supporters, what a reasonable government, not a mad government, should have done is to rent their own people to have their peace.
Of today do not understand those they are dealing with. They are dealing with old warriors, old oligarchists who know how to fight. One of the things they are going to do is that they are going to use fear and intimidation. They might roll the army out very soon, and they will shoot a few youths dead to intimidate others to run into their shells. The next thing they will do is to start arresting people piecemeal, to get hungry young men and individuals who are instruments that suffer from the Stockholm syndrome I told you. Remember Abacha's crisis? There was one young Igbo boy. I think it's Kanu that established one group. They went to Abuja, held conferences, held rallies to support Sani Abacha. But that was a great mistake they made. When they took Ijaw boys from the Niger Delta to Abuja, and they saw the next one they will do, and they're already doing it, is to play the North-South game. I saw some young men in the North with caps. They say they are youths. They say that they want SAS. They want SAS. I agree with you. It's a democratic setting. You have crisis in the North. But let me tell you, if the army could not defeat Boko Haram, SAS cannot defeat Boko Haram. Let me tell you the truth. Those young men or whoever who came with long caps, they are not the poor of the North. And they are watching us. I want to suggest that the international community, United States of America, the UK, France, they should be watching. Any oppressor, deny him and his children visa. Seize his assets overseas. Don't let them travel to your countries to come and enjoy democracy while they are killing us here. Seize their assets. Let's lock down these criminals of this nation inside this nation with us. We will see who will survive. God bless you. I remain your friend, Dr. Charles Apoki. The battle.
Professor Yemi Osinbajo, we know you're a man of great intellectual capacity for reasoning. You possess this great mental power of a gentleman, so we hope you'll be able to interpret our message
to the president.
But we need to tell you that we come in peace, so we are not miscreants. We are well-cultured human beings.
Remember, you swore an oath under the fifth schedule of the Constitution. You say you not allow your personal interests to influence your official conduct. You tweeted you understand how angry we are and you apologize.
See, Baba? This ex-Sars protest is to tell you how brutally cracked our hearts are.
There is no race that is as enduring and accommodating as Nigerians. Deep down in our hearts, we are still suffering, but yet we are still smiling. Imagine ordinary electricity we could not fix for 60 years.
Nigerian youth have been able to prove to you that we are more responsible, accountable, and transparent.
Nigerian witches and wizards are really falling our hand this time.
This is the time you really need to manifest your power in Nigeria.
The supposed giant of Africa is still a developing country. Chai, wahala really be like bicycle.
Mr. Vice President, Nigerians are the best set of human beings you can deal with.
Can't you see how we represent the countries in different nations? The government has been failing us since the 60s, but we hide under the canopy of ego better. Mr. Vice President, out of 10 people that go out a day, 3 might not come back alive because Nigeria is not safe.
This answer is to tell you that we are tired. What kind of country is this? We are not safe. Education is no more valuable.
Over 80 million people are living in extreme poverty. The Nigerian minimum wage cannot even buy a full bag of rice. Our parents will send us to school with their own hard-earned money, only for us to graduate with no job.
Police brutality has been too much that we demand immediate justice. Justice for Chijoke. Imagine a police officer boasting that he killed a citizen and there is nothing anyone could do about it. Putting the family through so much trauma. Tina Ezekwe was just standing in a bus stop. Kolade Johnson was killed in a football watching center. Tiamiyu Kazim was a young football star that was pushed out of a moving SARS vehicle. Ayomide Taiwo was killed because he refused to give a 15 naira bribe to the police officers. Ifeoma Abugu was raped and murdered in a police detention.
Nigerian police officers, don't you have human feelings? We understand that the government are not paying you people well. We all are fighting for the same thing. Why don't some of you join us and fight for the same cause?
As long as you are embroidered under Section 25
of the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, let me remind you that you are strong, hardworking, and resilient. It is not easy to be a Nigerian. I want you to know that we've already made an history that they can never lie to us about, an history that can never be forgotten. All we just need is a peaceful resolution. Even if you support or not, we move. Even if that violence or us, okay, we move.
Nigerians will never forget this day. The day we stood for our rights. The day we stood against injustice. The day we challenged the bad government and we hold them responsible. Those who killed our young ones and then offer us money for burial. ENSARS is just a slogan. This is an end to oppression. It is a mission of liberation. We are the wealth of the country. Needs to be redistributed. Police brutality is even the least of our problems.
Very soon, our political party will be registered.
We are tired of failed promises. Justice needs to be served as soon as possible. The same SARS who killed innocent citizens might also be in new SWAT uniform. You need to govern us well. Remember, you are our public servant. And please, we demand you make us happy.
The youth have given you a golden opportunity to write your name in our hearts forever. So please, do something.